American Detox, The Myth of Wellness and How We Can Truly Heal by Kerri Kelly. Narrated by Kerri Kelly. Published by North Atlantic Books. The figure and list of resources can be found in the PDF that comes with this audiobook. For my mother, who taught me how to be a strong feminist without knowing it, this book is for you. Forward. Reverend Angel Kyoto Williams, writer, activist, ordained Zen priest, and author of Radical Dharma. We were headed into the 2012 election with Barack Obama running for his second term. I'd spent the last 4 years dismayed by how underengaged the well-meaning white convert Buddhists that I'd come up around were. After the shock of a black man being swept into the highest office in the land, I let myself believe that some small corner had been turned. I certainly didn't think that we were post-racial, as people hilariously trotted out, but I did expect there to be some kind of meaningful engagement. I even wrote an essay, Finally American, as an ode to feeling a connection to that concept taken for granted by white people, being American, that had eluded me for all of my politically conscious life. I thought that having put themselves on the line to get him voted in, those same good white people would support him. When it turned out that the white people I thought were good overwhelmingly weren't actually voting, I was simply not having it. Like any good spiritual activist, I needed to not just sit there, but do something. I grew up black and queer in New York, thumping, jumping, and blasting the beats of misogynist hip-hop while steering an organization that would help define the third wave of feminism. Contradictions, anyone? Eventually, I was called into formal Zen meditation practice, which offered me a way to transmute pain I'd held without having an answer for why. Through yoga, I found my way back into a body that had been the subject of secret violences and violation visited on me as a child by people that I loved, and eventually learned had endured great violence themselves. In earth-based practices, my disconnect from the natural world began to dissolve. These equipped me with an ability to be integrated and hold complexity, but also steadied my unwillingness to not name what was present. As I saw how the movements of my time were being consumed by the culture they were steeped in, urgency, aggression, and relentless competition, I joined with a loose network of other people committed to justice and grounded by spiritual practice who knew a transformation of the larger culture was called for. The inner meets outer of what we had been calling this work needed a name. I coined the phrase transformative social change to speak to the idea that without inner change, there can be no outer change, and without collective change, no change matters. I was led to Kerri because we'd had the same epiphany. The so-called higher level consciousness of the spiritual, not religious, mystic, non-dual, East meets West paradigm had spawned what is arguably one of the most disruptive industries to run counter to the aggressive American Marlboro Man meets Mad Men, hyper-masculine, hyper-individualistic narrative, wellness. The wellness world had all the right principles: nonviolence, compassion, ecological consciousness, interdependence. Why wouldn't they have the right politics? We both saw an enormous potential that could be unleashed for good. We just needed to get them off their oming so peaceful I can't be bothered asses and to the polls. So in 2012, that's what we set out to do. I like to say that Kerri Kelly and I share an unlikely twinship. There we were, New Yorkers in California, and in no time at all, it was revealed that not only were we from the place where people actually say what they mean, but also we both have firemen fathers nicknamed Butch. From the beginning, we shared an awareness of how our various identities intersected and shaped us. It wasn't just an obligatory politeness. We were implicitly saying, you need to know this about me. And embedded within that, the many possible lines of convergence and divergence. Class was named. Race was explicit. The demands, points of access, and limitations of our respective locations were laid bare. We weren't just telling each other where we were from. We were telling each other where we were from. The whole "we'll just get them to vote" project didn't turn out well. Two conventions and a month of exhaustion later, we realized that the problem wasn't generic apathy, it was whiteness. This is where American Detox comes in. American Detox is the kind of book that is going to catch some flack. You can't challenge the status quo and expect that it won't ruffle feathers. If Kerri had written a book that simply extended the caboose of the culture of vitriol, finger-pointing, shaming, and canceling that we now desperately cling to avoid having that finger pointed our way, lots of us could happily hop on the bandwagon and parade above the avenue on our high and mighty, smart-ass, progressive hovercrafts, sailing over the ever-growing basket of deplorables. All the people we don't agree with or like, that don't have the right politics, aren't woke enough, don't keep up with the latest lingos, or just can't afford to get on, well, they will just burn as we sail above it all. But American Detox doesn't stop at ruffling feathers. It swipes left the platforms that we stand on and pontificate from. It's an ocean of truth-telling that swallows up all the ways we hide from treading into the deep waters of who am I really, when so much of what I believed myself to be has been shaped by a culture that never wanted me to see beyond the veil. Little by little, the straight look into the face of falsehoods we were weaned on plunges daggers into the chinks in the armor of domination thinking that keeps some of us cocooned in a narcotic sense of safety. No doubt, some Black and brown folks may take umbrage to a white woman talking about race. Because, you know, the system of capitalism favors and rewards white women and white people generally, even when they are saying the things we couldn't say without getting hurt or killed. It's a fair critique and an understandable place of pain for many of us. I say that from firsthand experience of having my first book, A Primer on Zen Buddhism, dismissed by some as a Black book, while white self-proclaimed Buddhist women could write about their experience, and that didn't make it a white book. And yet, us Black and brown folks have spent a long, long time telling white folks to go get your people. We won't change the system by who we hold back, but by supporting those we trust and can get through the gates to go forth and throw wrenches in the gears of the system until they will cease to turn. Kerri walks with a pocket full of wrenches. The beauty and the blessing is that in American Detox, Kerri doesn't wave a smug flag from atop a mountain of knowing. She walks the journey of asking the questions with us every step of the way. Not showing us how it's done, but pointing at resources and practices we might use to begin to undo it, if we choose to. American Detox is presented like good medicine, a bitter pill to swallow, but confident in the healing that comes about when a living system is relieved of the toxicity that overwhelms it. There's an abiding trust that whoever we are, when we strip the layers away, let the toxic beliefs and ways of thinking and being be confronted and allowed to flow through and out of our systems, we are worthy of returning to a basic wholeness. Not getting somewhere, returning. There's no promise to become super, better, uber, extra, more anything but you. And not alone, together. As a collective member of humanity. As Taj James reminds us, to the last breath, we are not afraid, because we know who we are, and we know we are a continuation of those who came before us, and we know those who come after us will be a continuation of us, and there is nothing to fear. Introduction. Waking up. For a seed to achieve its greatest expression, it must come completely undone. The shell cracks, its insides come out, and everything changes. To someone who doesn't understand growth, it would look.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.